All right, excellent. Thank you so much, Sherry Kang. They're live up in Seoul, SBS CNBC. Swing south now. National Australia Bank today denied reports it is cutting jobs to boost its bottom line, telling the Australian Financial Review, the AFR, the market chatter is just not true. NAB, not the only bank that has been rumored to be considering doing away with some positions. That's a nice way to put it. Lenders around the world have been working to overhaul operations because of tighter regulations and tougher trading conditions. Banks in the U.S., also in Europe, have been more aggressive in reducing their workforces than their Asia Pacific counterparts, but that trend could be starting to shift. For more, Paul Endicott joins us, Managing Director at recruitment outfit Ambition. We like that name a lot. He joins us around the desk here at the SGX together with our guest host, David Kuo from The Motley Fool. Paul, good to see you and appreciate the time. For financials and hiring out here in Asia, what's going on, the trends?
I think we look at this year and we look at the financial markets, obviously it's very challenging. I mean, that's been well documented. So there's been a number of different cuts going on. Now, if we look at Asia Pacific generally, a lot of those cuts have meant offshoring from higher cost locations like Singapore and Hong Kong. So if you look at operations, technology, they're not moving away from the Asia Pacific, they're actually just being moved to different locations like Philippines, Malaysia, India. So what you're tending to see here is, yes, there's offshoring and there's cuts in the regional centers where there's a lot of focus, but they are being moved to other centers of a lower cost.
Now moving out of the region, David.
I mean, job cuts over in the West, I mean, they're ranging in six digits at the moment. I look at banking and I just think it's a cyclical business. So we're in a down cycle at the moment. Is that the way you read it, that we're going to see an up cycle and then they're going to start hiring again?
I think recruitment generally for us is cyclical anyway. So what you tend to see is at the beginning of the year it's always quite quiet, bonuses are going to be paid in a month's time, and the reality is if you look at some areas of banking, particularly investment banking, bonuses aren't going to be great, so there'll be a natural attrition. And there won't be a significant increase in expansion. You look at transaction banking, retail banking though, you look at the rise in the middle income markets in Indonesia and Malaysia, then actually that is going to see a spike in hiring. So it depends on the location you're looking at. I don't think you can look at APAC as, when we say APAC before, we really meant Tokyo, Hong Kong and Singapore as the primary financial centers. Now, if you look at retail banking, transaction corporate banking, actually there's a lot of growth within the emerging markets right now.
Are the bonus models moving closer towards performance-related pay because of this backlash against executive compensation?
Absolutely. I mean, there's a significant amount of scrutiny now within what banks are paying, particularly around bonuses. I think if we look at this year from what we're hearing, bonuses have been announced probably this week and will be paid over the course of the next month. Bonuses will probably be down about 20 to 30% at the very senior levels. And I think at the more junior levels, below average or average, performers will get zeros and they'll be retained for the talent pools. But the reality is that's probably how it should be. You know, you look at other industries, that's how it works.
Okay. Got to ask you, financial services in Asia, what are the hot jobs? There was a while, there's a time not too long ago when everybody wanted compliance people, right? Yeah. Are they full up?
No, and I think if we look at the rise in sort of and the focus around the regulations around Basel III and Dodd-Frank coming through, that will be a significant area of hiring for the investment banks in the next 6 months. So the challenge we have around regulatory, finding strong regulatory risk professionals, compliance professionals, those challenges remain. So I think those will
be
hot areas.
Is that the hottest sector or are there others that are even hotter?
Those are going to be the hottest sectors within that area. Private bankers are still very much in demand generally, but you look at projects, so a lot of organizations are looking at how they can actually bring their platforms together, so projects, technology roles, risk, compliance, regulatory are probably the key areas within the financial markets.
Is the reason why many of the banks in the West moving to the East because it is cheaper to hire over here than it is in the West?
It depends on the roles. I mean, from what I've heard and what I understand, a VP in Singapore could cost as much as a VP in New York right now. So at the senior level, Singapore and Hong Kong will remain the strategic hubs. They're still the destinations of choice for people coming from the US or the UK to the markets that will always attract a premium. When you go outside and you look at somewhere like Malaysia, for example, you're 40% down in terms of
salary. What the politicians are saying in the West is not really because they're just hiring cheap labor over here then.
Certainly not when you look at the main financial census.
Very quickly, wage inflation, if we could. I mean, there was a time not too long ago when, you know, you looked at wages here in Singapore, over in Hong Kong. Hong Kong, there was always a 20, at some stage, even a 30% premium. Mm-hmm. How much has that narrowed?
significantly. I mean, when we get a brief, normally, and they're looking at Hong Kong and Singapore, they'll pay a comparable salary. There might be, you know, a 10% differential, but it's minor right now.
It's not a COLA thing, right?
Sorry?
Not a COLA thing.
No. No, I mean, I think ultimately Singapore certainly gained in traction and prestige as well over the previous year. So if you're looking actually attracting talent at a senior level, Singapore's a very easy place to come to. Yeah. And actually we've seen a number of people moving from Hong Kong down to Singapore.
Does it also mean, though, that Singapore, the cost of living here has now risen up to, it's the same as Hong Kong's?
It's still a little less, but it's certainly not as big a gap as it was two, 3 years ago.
Interesting. Okay, Paul, great to talk to you. Okay. Appreciate the time. Thanks for dropping by. See you again soon. Paul Endicott there from Managing Director at Ambition. And more to come with our guest host, David Kuo from The Motley Fool. Questions for him, email us at squawk@cnbcasia.com. All right, morning call is next on Squawk Asia. Deirdre Wong-Morse is on deck.